Next, we're going to learn about variables. A variable is just a reference to a piece of data that we can use later in the script. Earlier, we wrote a script where we printed out the string 24 hours. In that case, the data is the string 24 hours. But what if we wanted to print out the amount of time it takes to drive between two cities? The amount of time it takes to drive from San Francisco to LA is different from the time it takes to drive from LA to Seattle. Depending on the two cities, you're going to get a different value each time. So we're going to store that value in a variable before we print it out to the console. To create a variable, first we have to give it a name. A variable's name can contain letters, numbers, and underscores, but it has to start with a letter or an underscore, not a number. Also, variable names are case-sensitive in Lua, so var underscore A is not the same as var underscore capital A. These would be two separate variables. I'll call this variable length. This name is what you will use to refer to this variable later in the script. Then, we need to assign a value to length. We can do that with an equal sign, followed by the value we want to store. Let's say it takes 2 hours to get where we're going, so we'll set the length variable equal to 2. So, we have the variable name, length, followed by an equal sign, and the value we want to store, the number 2. Then, we can take this length variable and use it in our print function. Go ahead and delete everything from the print function, and just enter the variable name, length, with no quotes. If I save it and run the script, it displays the value of the length variable, 2. But before, we included hours after the value. To do that here, we need to concatenate a string onto this variable. We know that the only thing that is going to change is the number of hours, so we only need to include the number in the variable. We'll concatenate hours on after the variable in the print function. To concatenate values in Lua, type a space, and then two dots, another space, and then the value you want to append. So we'll enter two quotes, and inside the quotes, put a space, and then hours. I'll save the script and run it. And now we print out 2 hours. If the trip was going to be 5 hours, all we would need to do is change the 2 into a 5, save, and run the script, and we get 5 hours. Variables are useful if you're using this value in multiple places in your script. Imagine if you're using the length to represent how many miles the trip is, and you want to display it to the user. And also use it to calculate how much gas will be used on the trip. The length value would be used in several different places in the script, and if you didn't use a variable, you'd need to change the value in each place in the script. With a large program, this can be a problem, but using variables lets you set the value once, with the rest of the script using the same value. You don't have to store just numbers in variables either. Variables can contain many different types of data, like strings or booleans. We'll look at data types in the next video. Variables can even be assigned the value of other variables. If I create a new variable, called dupe underscore length, and set it to equal length, and I change the print function to print out the dupe length variable, it displays 75. Don't worry about why you would do that for now. Just make sure you know how to create a new variable by naming it, using only letters, numbers, and underscores, and how to assign a value with the equal sign and the value you are assigning. Finally, make sure you know how to print the variables that you create to the console using the print function.